From Saigon, this is the American Forces Vietnam Network. Let's have some fun.
Good morning, Vietnam. Welcome to the Dawn Buster.
Beneath it snowy metal cold and pain, the unborn grass lies waiting for its coat to turn to green. The snowbird sings the song he always sings.
Tonight, a personal report by the Daily Mirror's special correspondent, John Pilger. Vietnam, 1970, the front line.
I hadn't been to Vietnam for 3 years. The war, after all, is a bore, so why go back? What is there left to say? Surely we've seen it all on telly. But our boredom has not made the war go away, so I've come back for the final act. No blood, no atrocities. Just the rejection of the war by those sent here to fight it. Just the quiet mutiny of the greatest army in history. This is Snuffy, some 8 miles from the Cambodian border, in a wilderness of jungle and mud, controlled by the North Vietnamese and the Viet Cong. Snuffy is a beleaguered fort, defended by the 1st Air Cavalry Division. The scene there looks so familiar, like a faded snapshot of another war we wish to forget half a century ago, with its trenches and mud and barbed wire and boredom, and young men and their puppies. Snuffy is important because it's the end of the line for the grunts. They are the 18-year-old drafted kids, the national servicemen on whom the entire army depends. They are the ones to whom the buck is finally passed from the President and the Pentagon and the career men who catch colds in their air-conditioned command posts. Out of 400,000 American soldiers in Vietnam, only 80,000 fight, and almost all of them are grunts. Grunts in 1970 are a very different kind of American foot soldier. They are mostly from a world unknown to their commanders. They are the graduates of an American rebellion that stemmed from the war they have been sent here to fight. And quietly but massively, they have brought that rebellion with them here to Vietnam. For the grunts are unraveling the very fabric of the military. They are growing their hair, wearing love beads, smoking pot, flourishing the V sign of peace. And some are refusing to fight. The young men you see in this film are not a selected griping minority. I've spoken to hundreds of young soldiers, and the rebellion they feel so deeply is everywhere.
To stop spread of communism. I don't want to see communism spread it all over the world. Nothing I can do about it. Just stay and do my time, which I'm going to do. Get out of Vietnam, go back to the world.
I couldn't see any purpose in the war back home. It never explained to me why we're actually here. And I really had nothing against these people. I want to kill them. And you go out in the woods, and they'll shoot at you first. You'll see them, they'll shoot you if they get the chance. You have to shoot at them first. It's really bad. I still don't know why I'm here. That's God's truth. 3 months, and I don't know why I'm shooting these people.
Today is the day.
The grunts are the wheels of the Green Machine, the name they give the military. The Green Machine is comic book America with flesh on it.
Today is the day for you to let people...
A wonderland of heroes and slogans. In the Green Machine, a grunt doesn't seek out the enemy. He goes hunting for gooks. The Green Machine plays games, like Wandering Soul.
Wandering Soul is a tape that has been put out by the Psychological Operations Battalion and Benoit. It's used by the operating divisions and separate brigades to broadcast a rally appeal to the Viet Cong. The tape itself is a rather weird one, with the funeral dirge music in the background and a father talking to his children saying he's died on the battlefield and he's trying to encourage his comrades to rally and join the just cause.
The Vietnamese people worship the souls of their ancestors, but this wandering soul is very different. It was conceived in an echo chamber by the US Army and is broadcast from a helicopter over jungle where the gooks are supposed to be hiding.
Còn tôi Ba đang về với con đi. Tôi đang về với mình đây. Nhưng tôi còn đâu mắng hình hài nữa. Tôi đã chết rồi má con bay ơi. Tôi thảm thương. Thảm thương biết chừng nào.
We drop, I'd say, about 800,000 leaflets a day. We tell them what's happened to them in their battles. We killed three of your people yesterday, and they know it. We tell them also that you're going to be killed this, you know, into the future. You could be killed, and why? We ask them to desert their unit and what will happen to them once they rally, how they will be well-treated. Well, actually, it's been pretty slow. So far this month, we've had five. Last month, we only had one. The object of dispersing our leaflets by helicopters, they'll take a bunch by hand and throw them out most of the time. Occasionally, trying to get a direct result of a PSYOPS mission, they'll take a whole carton, which you'll see, and just drop it right out, hoping to hit someone.
Let's have some fun!
You've got pride, and you're really proud of what you're doing, and proud of seeing what you have done in the past. And this division has lived on a proud heritage. MacArthur said it well. This division is first in almost everything.
General George Custer was in the cavalry, and now instead of rattling sabers, we have rippling rotor blades.
Lifers and grunts, the career men who command the rear, the kids who hold the front.
A lifer is a person that wants to make a career out of the Army, that they sit back in air-conditioned rooms and say, okay, you guys go out there and fight the war. We'll tell you where to go and how to do it. But all they do is sit back there and draw their combat pay for not doing nothing. We just sit back there on their butts.
A lifer is someone, to me, that stays in the Army 20 or 30 years and is... that's just his job. When you come in the Army and you're a grunt like us, well, we're just out in the boonies, humping to the big pack and all, fighting the Viet Cong and the NVA.
Who does the fighting, the grunts or the lifers?
The grunts. There are some lifers out there with us, but they don't see too much action on them.
Very few.
Lifers are always in the rear trying to run everything out in the field, and the grunts out there trying to do the best you can. Like the lifers is a... say like they're back here and like they say, go to this hill and this hill. They don't look at the terrain and everything and how rough it is and everything. And the grunt's the one that has to go through all the hell.
Grunt has to do the fighting.
Yes.
Out on patrol, 28 days out in the boonies, the green machine jargon for the bush, where the Indians are. Days of boredom, seconds of terror, a mile a day, waiting to be shot at, waiting to step on a mine. Boring waiting. On this patrol, we hear a chicken, and the captain says it may be a Viet Cong chicken. No lifer in his helicopter can kill that chicken. Only the grunts can kill that chicken, and its owner. On this patrol, the medic says to me, hey man, why doesn't TV show how boring this war is?
I'm Army Sergeant Roger Clay Ashworth. Have a good day now.
The difference between a lifer and a grunt is the lifer is supposed to know the why of it, and the grunt thinks there is no why of it. He's just over here, and it's we all count it in days. We can almost every one of these tell how many days we have left to do in Vietnam.
When you're out on long-range patrol with this sort of new kind of grunt, do you give orders or do you sort of enter into discussions?
It's a combination of both. It's not near as many orders as I thought it would be. There's an old saying in the United States Army that you don't tell American soldier, you tell him why. And I didn't believe it as much until I came to Vietnam, and I've had several times when I thought my people were being insubordinate because they wanted to know why. Or my NCOs thought they were being insubordinate because they wanted to know why. And maybe because of the emotions of the time, you know. I had to say, you'll do it, damn it, you know, because I say you'll do it.
If I had to do it over again, I would go to jail. For one thing, in California,
the max usually that you're going to get is 3 years. Okay, what's 3 years in the jail compared to 2 years in NOM or 3 years in the Army? I don't really think that there is going to be another generation of American soldier. I think that people are just tired of it. There's, you know, there will be people in the Army, but the people that really feel strong on it aren't going to go in.
Alrighty, Miss America, from Birmingham, Michigan.
Out of the sky drops Miss America and her friends, just for the grunts. Flown in with the ice cream, packaged, homogenized, untouchable white flesh. Fodder for dreams of home.
And as you can see, we've made it. But during our generation, we've heard the sounds of rockets in space, the miracles of science and medicine and surgery, the voices of men on the moon, and the youth of our America, some of yesterday's great and forever living semi-classics. And now that we're here, let's get down to that business we've been talking about. There'll be no sitting around and wondering as we bring you our sound.
Grunts are dying.
At a level acceptable to both the American military and the American public. Another 65 this week, about the same next week, and the next, until the very last American division, combat division, is withdrawn. And so far, for all the words from Washington, only paper soldiers have gone home. The war isn't over, but it is ending. It is ending not because of the Paris talks or the demonstrations at home. It is ending because the largest and wealthiest and most powerful organization on earth, the American Army, is being challenged from within, from the very cellars of its pyramid, from the most forgotten, the most brutalized, and certainly the bravest of its members. The war is ending because the grunt is taking no more bullshit.
I just don't like, I just can't take too much pressure from the Army. You know.
What happens to an unpopular officer out in the field?
Mostly unpopular officers, from what I heard, If they mess with a grunt too much, they get shot out there.
A friend of mine, Captain, kind of got shot in the back.
What was he doing? What was the captain doing to deserve being shot in the back?
From what my friend said, he was telling him just go on through, and they were getting hit pretty bad, and he was telling him just keep on going. He said no. He kind of got shot.
Well, yeah, there's a lot of mistakes, but you know, the grunts,
don't always do what the captain says, you know.
Yeah.
We got, see, the captain will stay back. He'll tell a platoon or something to go out so many hundred meters, you know. We don't do it.
Yeah.
We only go as far as we get out of sight, sit down, and come back in.
Yeah.
We don't want to hit contact. That's one thing we don't want to hit.
Vice President of the United States, Mr. Spiro T. Agnew, arrives in Vietnam. He visits the presidential palace in Saigon. Here he gives the President of South Vietnam a gift-wrapped filing cabinet, a token of his esteem.
Are you in need of a friend?
I need a friend. I need a friend.
Someone who tells you things, important things.
But I'd like to get to know you.
Someone who offers you a wide degree of interest. Sports, good books, interesting stories, girls. Well, the Stars and Stripes could be considered a friend.
After lunch, he will fly by helicopter to the heavily fortified American embassy. There he will meet the American ambassador and American generals and pass out ballpoint pens and posthumous medals. Tomorrow he leaves Vietnam, having been assured that all is well. He will meet no grunt.
A few months ago, when I was in the United States, this letter was given to me by a woman who lives in a small town in Ohio. The letter was written by her son, Kenneth, while he was serving in the infantry in Vietnam. I'd like to read it. Hello, Mom. Well, the shit has really started here. I've been in combat 2 months now, almost since the day I got here. I'm so confused about it, all I think some days is I'm going crazy. These people, the gooks, hate me, hate us all. So why am I almost dying for them? All the guys who are putting themselves on the line are grunts like me. We don't think this war is worth dying for. We don't think the lifers who won't fight are worth dying for. We've talked this out and we've decided to tell the company commander we're not working and walking into that bush again. At least we'll go to jail where it's safe. The afternoon Kenneth wrote that letter, he was killed. The telegram his parents received said he had died a brave man while storming a Viet Cong bunker. The medals they received said much the same thing. And the box they received, in which their son lay, was marked this way up, unviewable. How many Americans have been killed and wounded in Vietnam?
Through the 22nd of August, 43,418 U.S. killed.
How many U.S. troops are presently in Vietnam?
How many U.S. troops are presently in Vietnam? As of 20 August, 403,700.
Of these, how many are in ground combat? That is, they are likely to go out on a long-range patrol.
We don't break them out that way. We say that approximately 60% of our forces in country are in either combat or combat support units.
Would a figure of 80,000 be near?
A figure of what?
80,000.
I don't really know off the top of my head. I'd have to take that question.
Do you have a proportion of this for drafted men in Vietnam?
No, we have no proportions on what constitutes a breakout of draftees or enlistees. There possibly may be at the Department of Defense. We don't have it here in country.
How many American casualties have been caused by mistake in the field? Do you have a figure for that?
I'm sorry, I don't understand your question.
How many American casualties have been caused by mistake or accident, either in the field or on the base?
You're asking me for how many casualties by mistake or accident?
Yes.
I don't have the statistics here, I don't believe, but would you rephrase the question, because I don't quite understand.
Well, for example, when a man is killed by a friendly rocket, that is a mistake. How many people have been killed by mistake rather than have been killed by the enemy?
I see. You're now excluding any accidents like aircraft accidents or automobile accidents or this type.
No, including all those. All accidents, all mistakes.
I don't have those statistics.
There's no breakdown.
I'll find out for you.
Mm-hmm. Can you tell me what the desertion rate is for servicemen from Vietnam, or on leave from Vietnam, or on R&R for Vietnam?
That's I don't have that figure with me.
What you have just seen is the daily press briefing for correspondents in Saigon. There are 444 of us here this week, although very few bother to come to what is called the 5 o'clock follies. The reason they don't come is that they don't learn very much here. For 5 years, the follies have gone on with much the same theatrical staying power as a West End farce. Every day, the same evasions, the same euphemisms, the same jargon. For ordnance, read bombs. For interdiction, read blasting away at nothing in particular. The other week, the firebase ripcord had to be evacuated. It was, perhaps, one of the major defeats of recent months. It was referred to here as a redeployment of troops.
I've heard it said that the object of the follies is to lull the press into laziness and boredom. Just give them the old body count and they'll print it. And it's interesting that no major American newspaper ran the story of the massacre of Pinkville until competition forced it to. And one TV network is still using the same battle film over and over again. Perhaps this is why the war is such a bore.
My name is Colleen and I'm from Wisconsin. Anybody here from Wisconsin? No, with all you people?
As part of GAP, the Grunt Appeasement Program, at least that's what the grunts might call it, the donut dollies arrive at Snuffy. Donut dollies are girls of the American Red Cross sent to the front line to play games with the grunts. Good, clean novelty games, like Monopoly, quizzes, and Blind Man's Bluff.
Okay, what we're gonna do is ask you, toss some questions on trees. Okay?
Here comes the first question. Who cut the wilderness trail to Kentucky? Danny Boone, this side.
However, the novelty could be wearing off. The other day, a donut dolly was blown up by a grenade, and another was stabbed to death by grunts.
This one nobody's ever gotten, so it's going to be 20 points. What is the name given to the byproducts of the forest, such as turpentine and resin?
Sundries.
It's pretty obvious that nobody knows your job like you do, the guy who's doing it. Maybe you know a way it can be done better with the savings of time, money, or manpower. Don't sit on your good idea. Spell it out in writing and submit it to your services suggestion program.
I suppose some of you watching this film will say it's peddling the anti-American line yet again. Well, perhaps another kind of person could make another kind of film. But I've lived in America and I've been in the mud of America's war in Vietnam. And I do know that thousands of young American soldiers, like the grunts of Snuffy, are fighting an enemy that isn't called Gook. It's called the U.S. Army. And that takes guts. Out on patrol, one of my friends was the medic. And when I was leaving, he said to me, "Hey, man, tell them back in the world we're coming home, and we're never coming back."
I don't like violence. I try to stay out of much violence as I can, because violence is something not to. Violence is nothing to play with. You got to live your life the way you want to live it. If you want to live it in violence, you live it in violence. If you want to live it in peace, you live it in peace, and that's how I live my life: peace.
There's a woman traveling with two men. They opened fire on us. We had to shoot back. You know. I think it's bad to have to kill women and children, but over here it's necessary. Definitely against violence, but, you know, it's just 2 year span. I go back home, back to the old ways.
Yeah, I'm
thinking about my girls. I got a telegram 2 weeks ago and she died. It was a really bad thing. We were planning to get married and everything.
I
really ruined a lot of my plans. You know, now I just want to go home, start all over.
My wife's going to have a baby next month. I'm really looking forward to going home now.
That wraps it up this evening on Million Dollar Music from the Big VN. Saluting.